Bethany!
Hi, Jen!
Hey! This is the first time we've done a live from our beds.
I know. I'm really liking this, actually. I feel very relaxed.
It's very comfy. Hi, everybody. Welcome to Mom Cave Live, where we may have lost our minds, but we haven't lost our sense of humor yet. We won't. I'm Jen from MomCave, and this is my buddy Bethany Braun Silva. She is a parenting expert editor extraordinaire, and we're here tonight, sponsored by Cozy Earth, to talk about moms and sleep—two things that don't seem to go together as much as we would like, right?
No, not nearly as much as we would like.
Not nearly. I have a quiz. Are you going to be doing a quiz to see what we know?
I'm up for it. Yeah, let's do it.
So we have a quiz of strange parenting related sleep facts. And I would love everybody who's watching, if you want to join in on the comments. But let's give the shout out to Cozy Earth first. When I asked Bethany, do you want to do a sponsored live with me for Cozy Earth? She was like, Your sheets are cozier.
I mean, I love them. I have the sheets right now. They're so good. I mean, and we were talking about this before. I mean, like, anything with Oprah's stamp of approval, like, you really don't have to convince me too hard. I love them. They're so soft.
So apparently they were Oprah's favorite things on the list for like 5 years running. So they must be amazing. I had not heard of Cozy Earth until recently, and I got these awesome PJs and their sheets, which I have right here. And I'm going to share something. I'm going to share something here. We're women of a certain age. I think mine is like maybe older than yours, but they're a certain age. And women of my certain age tend to get very sweaty at night. It's disgusting. I don't know why. It just is the thing. It's been so bad for so long. And then I got the Cozy Earth sheets. I've been sleeping on them for 3 nights. And I have not woken up sweaty one time in 3 nights.
That's incredible. I love them for that reason too. But to me, they're really just like the softest sheets I've ever slept on. And wait, don't you love how they come in a little tote bag? Isn't that so cute?
I kept my tote bag to show everybody. So I don't know if I can get far enough away. Can you all see?
I love it. My mother wanted, like, she didn't, she was like, where did you get that? I was like, actually, that's what my sheets came in. And she like stole it from me. So
it's very cute. Yes. It's very, it has a pocket. I'm totally going to use this as like a tote bag purse. So basically they wick moisture. They're super luxurious and soft and wonderful sheets. And they have all kinds of loungewear and stuff. And they asked us to do this live and to share with you my coupon code, of course, is MomCaveTV. I believe that gives you $50 off. And somebody who buys from Cozy Earth tonight will win $200 credit.
That's amazing for
being a mom caver. So I'm going to flash up on screen that info real quick. Here we go. So I'll put all of that in the description and in the comments, and then we're going to do our quiz. So everybody, we want you to jump in and participate in our quiz with us. Okay. I had someone make up this quiz, and we're going to see what we know about moms and sleep, other than we don't get enough of it, right?
No.
Okay. And kids, and that they don't sleep enough. We know that. So according to the American Academy of Pediatrics, how many hours of sleep do we think that kids should get? And there's the two categories of like school age kids, 6 to 12, and teens, 13 to 18. So give me your guess and
okay.
Comments. How many hours of sleep? Suzanne Brooks said 10.
That's what I'm thinking. And also, this is so embarrassing because, you know, I'm a parenting editor and I'm a mom of two boys. I should be like, I should know this, but like, I'm not 100% sure. I think I might guess 10 as well.
You would guess 10. Okay. For ages 6 to 12, they recommend 9 to 12 hours.
I wish my kids slept 12 hours.
No, think of that. And teens, 8 to 10 hours.
All right.
Yeah.
I so, guess they do a lot of that growing overnight, right? Like they need that right. sleep.
The growing, the brain developing, all of that overnight. And it's so funny because we were just talking about this before we went live. My kids are so overscheduled right now that like with the baseball and the dance recitals and the after school that they're getting to sleep later and later. And I can tell they are grumpy.
But do you find like that they're worn out? Because my kid is very active too. My older son, he does baseball, he does all this, but he's still not able to like wind down. And I'm like, how much do I have to run you throughout the day right. for you to like go to sleep? But can you just imagine for a second, Jen, if your kids actually slept 12 hours straight?
Like, I mean, that's like half, let's just be honest, that's half the day. We don't need 12 hours of sleep. So that would give us quite a few hours.
Yes. Right?
Okay.
I
would like that very much. Well, my daughter is kind of like that. So I wonder, my daughter never will say she's tired, never has in her life said she's tired, always has more energy than me. But she basically like will just scream, I'm not tired, I'm not going to bed, until she does literally pass out.
She just collapses somewhere.
Yeah. So there's hope that at least the kid will collapse. Okay. This is my favorite question of the evening. Okay, you guys, weigh in. Who, according to experts, needs more sleep, men or women? What do you all think in the comments?
That's so funny. I mean, I don't know what the experts say, but I can tell you who gets more sleep in my house.
Right? Yeah. I think that whether it's a biological thing, because, you know, we have to like grow humans. So there's that. And like just having a body that's ready at any moment to grow humans, and then it's done growing humans, and then it's like recovering from that. All of the reproductive stuff. That's enough. All of the hormones. Suzanne Brooks is saying women, of course. But I think that even if that weren't a factor, and we're going to look at the answer in a minute, I think just like the carrying of all the things, the mental load, as they call it, is going to make us need more sleep.
Absolutely. That is so exhausting. That I would definitely say. I mean, for me, this is like a no-brainer. But I'm so curious. And if the answer is sort of like in opposite of what we're thinking, I really want to know who these experts are.
Right. Then they're fired. They're basically fired from being sleep experts now.
Right.
Okay, so this is according to researchers at the Loughborough University, UK-based Sleep Research Center. And they found that women do use their brains more than men.
All right, that tracks.
So much so that they do require more sleep.
All right, good job, guys. That was...
It's right here. It's in black and white, you guys. So if you need me to send this with, you know, annotations to your significant other.
Right.
So I'm so happy to do so. Okay, I just wanted to quickly see if I could show you all some of my cozy earth things. Let's see. Oh, here's how I do that. Do you know I can share a tab? It's like we're on a Zoom hanging out.
I love that.
See that? Can you guys see? Okay, these are just some of the amazing things that they have for women. And this is what I want. Can you see it on your screen, Bethany?
No, I can't. I can only see us. Let me see if I can.
Doing it wrong. View tab. Oh, maybe. I don't know. Oh, see, you see, this is why women also need more sleep, because our brains have to do a lot of things. And right now, there you go. My brain did that thing. Okay. So here's I'm just going to hide Bethany for 1 second to make this bigger. And you can see, this is the women's section. They've got stuff for women. They've got stuff for men. They have bedding. They have bath. Everything is so incredibly soft. And you can use my code MomCaveTV to get your credit. But wait, I wanted to show everyone very quickly the thing. Where did they go? They're these lounge pants. I mean, look at these. Like, you could wear these to pick children up at school. And look at that comfy sleep mask. Anyhow, that is why you want to go check out that website. It's amazing. And I'm bringing Bethany back on because we have more parenting quiz questions to go. Okay, so we did Who Needs More Sleep? When do most babies start sleeping through the night? And they define that as 6 to 8 hours of sleep.
Ooh, that's a good one.
What do you guys think? Comment and tell us. When do you think most babies, the average baby, start sleeping through the night?
Yeah, I'm thinking of my own kids, and they were, of course, so, like, vastly different that it's, like, no real barometer.
Jessica is saying 4 months.
4 months. Ooh.
4 months. Good for you.
Yeah, really. I was going to say, like, more like eight to ten.
8 years?
No. Yeah, right.
For my daughter, definitely 8 to 10.
Right. 8 to 10 months, but it's not like, for me at least, it wasn't like consistent. It was like 8 to 10, maybe like 4 times a week I would get, like, you know, through the night.
Yeah. Yeah. But, I was always surprised when I had my first and they said 6 hours was what they defined as sleeping through the night, because I was like, that's not enough sleep for me.
No.
So if the baby isn't sleeping the whole way through what I need to sleep, that's not through the night. Suzanne Brooks says probably a year. Well, like I said, in my own experience, I have my youngest child still does not sleep through the night. Every single night she wakes up, uses the bathroom, and then comes to find me. And the last few nights it's been with the cozy earth sheets, and it's making it harder for her not to sleep in my bed, I do have to say.
I will say my 7-year-old's obsessed with them too. Like, so there's this whole thing with, like, you know, do people even use, like, the top sheet anymore? And admittedly, like, I don't, but I do with the cozy earth because he's obsessed. It's like his favorite thing to just, like, cuddle with. So we do break out the cozy earth top sheet.
That's great. Yeah, we should do a whole live on that. Like, there are people with very strong opinions about sheets.
My mother is so pro top sheet, she can't really even fathom the idea that people aren't using it. For her, it's like she can't even believe it.
Mine too. She's like, it's I don't use one either. It's like she thinks we're savages.
Right.
Yeah. Yes. Like, did I raise you in a barn?
Like, disgusting.
Okay. See, I lost my train of thought again because moms don't get enough sleep.
Right.
So this was according to Stanford Medicine Children's Health. They said that the average baby will sleep through the night at about 3 months old or when they weigh about 12 to 13 pounds. Well, I knew my kids weren't average, but.
Right. And what about all that sleep regression? Like, oh, come on. I don't buy that one.
I mean, Stanford, I know they're all official, but I don't know about that.
Me neither. Okay. I'm not buying that one.
I'm not buying it. I'll believe what I want to believe. Right. Okay. So here's a good one. How many hours of sleep do we think the average mom gets a night and the average dad gets a night?
Ooh.
Pop your answer in the comments.
I'm so curious to see what other people say about this.
I'm very curious. I'm always curious about other people's sleep. Like, do I sleep not enough, too much? Are other people like me? You know, it's so.
Yeah. And as summer's sort of creeping up, I know I've been pushing the bedtime later and later, even though they're still in school for like another couple weeks. But that bedtime is getting up there now that, like, it's lighter outside. So
I know. Well, the little league is keeping us up till, like, you know, we didn't get home till after 8 o'clock last night. So
thank goodness.
It is crazy. Okay. I'm waiting to see if anybody has any guesses on this one. On the average mom's night sleep and the average dad's night sleep. So let's say Suzanne has one. She thinks mom 5 to 7, dad 7 to 10.
Yeah, I was going to say women 6, dad's probably that solid 8.
Okay. I'm going to say in my family, I do have to admit I get more sleep than my husband because I always have felt that I need more sleep than him, and I'm right. And he works weird hours. So I don't know. In our family, it's not that. Okay. So the actual answer is, dun, 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 you know, where did I put the actual answer? Where is the actual answer?
We could probably Google it real quick.
Oh my Lord. Well, I guess I lost the answer because I've lost my mind because children and sleeping, but we will Google that.
Let's go with what was it, Suzanne? I liked her answer.
Suzanne, okay. This is all about being live and being spontaneous. So how many hours of sleep does the average mom get?
God bless the internet, right?
Okay, but we have to have a good source. Healthline says between 5 and 6 hours of sleep.
All right, that's not enough. What?
Okay, I'm not even going to look for the dads because it's obviously more than that.
It has to be, right? Someone's got to be sleeping in your household.
Somebody has to be sleeping. So if you go over to CozyEarth.com and use this discount code, you will get a credit on something fabulous like these very soft PJs or these very soft sheets. And I'll put that all like in the description in the comments later. So we have, I think, two more questions. Let's see. We have three.
Okay.
This is a good one. Speaking of top sheets and fitted sheets, when do you think fitted sheets were invented, Bethany?
Oh my gosh. I never even thought about something like that. I just assumed they were always around as long as we had beds.
Well, I guess you needed elastic, right?
Right.
Right?
1930-something? I don't know. I'm terrible at stuff.
1930-something is a good guess. Before fitted sheets, it was just sheets. And so you just folded the sheet over.
And you had to like tuck it in, probably hotel right. style, I'm thinking.
Totally. The answer is 1959 was when it was first patented.
Okay.
1959. They're pretty new.
Yeah.
A child has entered the room, everyone.
Uh-oh.
You have poison ivy. Well, that's a problem. You went in the woods. Oh, my goodness. The whole internet will know. Okay, well, let me finish this up, and then we'll take care of the poison ivy, okay? Living in the country is craziness. Okay.
It's so funny. Your child entered the room. My child has been here the whole time.
Well, yours is being quiet. That's amazing.
He has the TV on really low.
That's how we do it. This is how moms do it. Okay. We have one more question. Okay. Okay. And this one is, according to this old house, which we all know is a good source for anything, how long do single people and married people go before changing their sheets?
Oh my goodness. I feel like I might have changed them more when I was single because I had more time.
You have more time. Also, I don't know, depending if you thought maybe you were having someone over that you wanted to impress, you might change your sheets more often.
Exactly. And I mean, I know I'm not the only parent out there who has definitely thrown a towel over to like a little bit of puke or maybe right. a little pee because you were so exhausted. Just too went back to sleep.
To change the sheets. Right. Yeah. Anybody got any, let's see. Yeah. Suzanne's saying she means like wash them. Yeah, we mean change them and wash.
Like put clean ones, take the dirty ones off, put the clean ones off.
Yeah, clean sheets. Yeah, she's guessing once a week. Okay. Now, this old house says that on average, single people go 37 days before changing their sheets.
Oh my goodness.
Those in relationships married couples go 19.9 days.
That's still a little too long.
That's a little too long, guys. Now, I'm not judging anybody because I probably have done that, but I try not to.
Yeah. I mean, the towel thing I mentioned was just like the middle of the night. And then when I woke up the next day,
just leave it there. Right.
Right. Oh, I'm shocked about that, actually.
A little shocked on that note. Like, you need whoever this is, if they had the Cozy Earth sheets, maybe. They would love it so much because they're so soft and so wonderful that they would change them more often and wash them and take care of them.
Yes, I take really good care of mine, actually. They say no softeners, nothing like that. Like, I really do take good care of mine.
Yeah, what is the washing situation with these sheets, Bethany? You must know.
Yeah, I love these sheets so much. And, you know, they're a bit of a splurge, but well worth it. I, read the instructions, and I'm pretty sure you sort of wash with, like, you know, a good detergent or your normal detergent, but no fabric softener, and then just tumble dry low. That's what I do so that they last a long time. And they do. And they're also, and I don't quote me on this, but I feel like they get softer with each wash. Like, ooh. I think they might be fabricated to do that. Like, the That's more the more that you use them and wash them, they get softer. So I don't know if that's like an official feature of them, but for me, that's definitely been the case. They're incredible.
Yeah, they're made of bamboo. They're super wonderful and organic and all natural and all the good things. You don't have to worry. And your children will want to be in your bed even more than they did
before. I know. It is past 8. I get it. Like,
I know. Guys, thank you so much for watching. I want everybody to get some sleep tonight. I know. We've got poison ivy to take care of.
Oh, no. I feel like your night is like just beginning. It's not winding down. It feels
it's not winding down. But when it does, after everyone's in bed and everything's cleaned up and the lunches are packed and all, I am going to relax here in my cozy earth sheets, cozy earth PJs, and they're gonna. hopefully not, but probably with her, and it's gonna be amazing. So you guys go check out cozyearth.com, use my discount code, and somebody who orders tonight is going to get a $200 credit, and she just said,
"Nope, you're not saying it."
You're welcome.
No!
You can say it. You can say it. You can say it, crazy girl. What do you want to say it?
No, you're not saying it either.
She wanted me to say subscribe.
Subscribe.
Okay. I've been doing this for too long, y'all. Thank you for hanging out with me, Bethany.
Of course. This was so much fun. Thank you.
I know. Enjoy your sheets, everybody. Enjoy your PJs and be cozy.
They're comfortable.
They are.